From the cradle to the grave, football borders on religion in the state of Alabama. This timeless phenomenon solidified some 70 years ago. It was during the Depression of 1929 and on into the 30s when the hopeless Alabama citizens looked with pride towards the great Crimson Tide teams. In this era, Wallace Wade and Frank Thomas won 4 national championships, soothing the desperate times. When America rebounded, Alabama football continued to be the toast of the upper crust. The state's doctors, lawyers, and bankers sent their children on to Tuscaloosa to be educated. Auburn University was an agricultural and engineering school, attracting the state's middle class. Auburn always felt it was being shunned by the University of Alabama followers, and Auburn knew the one place to gain respect from Tuscaloosa was on the football field. For the past 40 years, these social wars have been settled on a battleground in Birmingham. These two teams have met on the last weekend of their seasons to settle 364 days of impassioned arguments over who has the better team and the better way of life. When Alabama and Auburn play, the goal is to win, but the fear is of losing and having to tolerate your arch-rival fans and their incessant torture for an entire year. People said it would never happen. Today, it will happen. Second-ranked Alabama against 11th-ranked Auburn. In Auburn for the first time ever.
You better buckle your seatbelts because it's going to be a show to watch. You better tie your TV set down, but if you're going to stay at home, just and watch it because it just may jump right off the stand.
Clack's going to throw in the end zone. Got him in wide open wide, but he's got it.
Welcome to Jordan-Hare Stadium, where anything can happen. Auburn Tiger football is on the air. The first ever true Auburn home game against Alabama. Now, here's the voice of the Auburn Tigers, Jim Fyffe.
Some said it would never happen. There have been lawsuits, arguments, discussions, and fights over moving this game out of Birmingham, where it's been played every year since 1948. And where some said it would always be played. How wrong they were. Because today, history is being made, and the biggest crowd this school has ever hosted is on hand to watch the 54th edition of football's hottest rivalry. The nation's second-ranked team, the Alabama Crimson Tide, brings an undefeated record into Jordan-Hare Stadium. Needing a victory over 11th-ranked Auburn to keep alive its hopes of a national championship. The Tigers, meanwhile, are playing this one for a share of their third straight SEC championship and looking to extend their string of wins over Bama to 4 straight. Hello again, everybody in War Eagle. This is Jim Fyffe with Charlie Trotman. Larry Wilkins, our engineer. The producer is Bruce Chestnut. Mike Murphy, the statistician. Kes Fabian and Bill Winger are the spotters today. Never in the history of this storied series have emotions run as high. Maybe it's because the game is being played on Auburn soil for the first time. Perhaps it's because of Bama's great season. Maybe a combination of both and other reasons that we haven't even considered. Whatever the case, you can almost see the sparks flying this afternoon in Jordan-Hare Stadium. Weather will not be a factor. Weather conditions are nearly perfect for today. A high in the low 60s is predicted. No rain is in the forecast. This one is rated by the odds makers as a toss-up. It has all the trappings of a classic matchup today. Auburn, after a gain of 1 by Danley, looks at 3rd down and 5 to go at its 49-yard line. Webb and Rayum are the ends. Thornton and Hammond are the tackles. Wyatt is at the nose for the tie. Again, they break up the eye set. Danley becomes a wing on the left. Both ends are split away. Reggie Slack needing 5 yards. On 3rd down, is going to throw long to Alexander Wright. Oh, a great catch over the shoulder inside the 10, down to the 7-yard line. As he beat Ephraim Thomas, who made the tackle down at the 7, Reggie Slack threw a beautiful pass, and Wright took it over his left shoulder as he raced down that eastern sideline.
Reggie Slack. quarterback came up to the line on a third and five, he saw that Alabama was playing man-to-man in the secondary. They were in a blitz situation. They had Keith McCants coming toward the quarterback. Auburn's offensive line needs the credit. Great pass by Reggie, great catch by Alexander, but the pass protection was there, allowed Reggie to get the ball off.
Wideouts to the left in a slot formation, Overton and Wasden. They break up the eye again. They've got Strong and Danley in the backfield. Danley on the carry, splits through a little seam inside the five to the one, and down at the goal line is Danley, straight up the gut. It'll be third down and goal inside the Bama one. He was tripped up by Osment and Thomas. Third down and goal. All right, here's Auburn, third down and goal just inside. It's one full house backfield, two tight ends. Give up the middle, over and in is Joseph as he dives in. Touchdown, Auburn! James Joseph took the handoff from Reggie Slack and just went airborne, catapulting his way over the Alabama defenders and into the end zone. And Auburn has struck quickly with 12-10 left in the first quarter. The Tigers lead 6-0. Wynn Lyle is on for the point after touchdown. Dickinson to hold. This crowd, the Auburn side, obviously celebrating. I think the Alabama fans may be a little stunned at the turn of events. The kick by Lyle on its way. The kick is good. Auburn 7, Alabama nothing. Battle and Wembley, the wide receivers, split to either side. Hollingsworth's going to operate from the shotgun on a third and 7 situation at his 42. Long snap count by Gary Hollingsworth. Takes that long snap. Hollingsworth chased out of the pocket. Hit. He's dropped. He is sacked by Big Mike Campbell for a big loss back at the 33-32-yard line. The Auburn pass rush doing what it has to do, and that is putting the pressure on Gary Hollingsworth. Doyle to kick, and Ward holding for him. The ball on the near side hash mark. Angle back to the right, a 23-yard fake attempt. Rolling out as the holder. He's in a lot of trouble. Throws a pass in the end zone. Is it caught? No. Broken up. Incomplete. The holder, Jeff Wall, rolled out to his right, threw a pass in the end zone, broken up in there by Ogletree and Billingsley. David Lenore was the intended receiver, and Alabama has failed inside the Auburn 5 on 4 tries. Wideouts left and right. Saran Stacy and Kevin Turner in the backfield. A play fake, rolling out and setting up, and unable to throw the ball. Sacked is the quarterback, Hollingsworth, by Ricky Sutton. Hollingsworth pump faked, and I thought he was going to throw it out in the flat, but Sutton all of a sudden was in his face, Charlie, and swarmed all over him for a big loss back to the Bama 44. Alabama 3 out of 6 on third down plays as Hollingsworth runs from the shotgun, gets a low snap, chased out of the pocket. Ogletree's got him. He is sacked back at his 42-yard line. Alabama was running from the shotgun. Auburn fired Ogletree, and Craig sacked quarterback Hollingsworth. That's the third quarterback sack on Alabama. Hollingsworth losing yardage back to the 42, and Bama will have to punt as Bill Smith checks in.
One of the reasons that's so effective is it was third and long. Alabama could not use the play action fakes as effectively.
Donnie Finkley is now the Alabama wide receiver. They move tight end Lamon Russell over to the right, and another tight end, Charlie Abrams, is on the left. A fake, and here's the end around of Lamon Russell trying to turn the corner to the far side. He's in trouble. He'll lose yardage. Russell knocked off his feet back inside his 45-yard line by Billingsley. Loss on the play. Riggins hustled over there to help out, and they got him for a 5-yard loss.
Well, Jim, Lamon Russell has only had one carry the exact same play earlier this year, but that time it went for 21 yards and a big play for Alabama in a big ball game. This time Auburn, anticipating it, sniffed it out from the outset.
Strategy for the second half in a nutshell.
We're gonna come back and try to run basically what we've done. Hopefully we can go into the fourth quarter with the game close as it is now, and then we're gonna have a chance.
Wasden to the far side, or the short side of the field, right to this side. Taylor's in the slot to the left. Here's Slack. He's going to throw. He's got Wasden open at midfield. 45, 40. Wasden's in a foot race at the 30, the 25, the 20. Stumbles, tripped up, falls to the ground at the Alabama 10-yard line. Somebody grabbed him by a shoestring from behind. It was Keith McCants, the All-American linebacker, and he rambles 60 yards. to the Alabama 10-yard line. McCants, the last man who had a chance at little Shane Wasdin, who has figured so prominently in Auburn victories over LSU and Florida. That time, Wasdin going for 60 yards. McCants just made a dive and grabbed an ankle, tripping him up, and he stumbled forward to the Bama 10. Joseph and Danley, both in the Alabama and the Auburn backfield. They'll line up in the eye. Wide outs to either side for Reggie. Here's the snap. The play fake by Slack. He rolls left. He's going to throw a pass complete to Joseph. Joseph 10, Joseph 5. Joseph is down right there at the pylon in the near corner of the end zone, hit by Van Treese Davis. But Auburn is going to be third down, goal to go at the one-inch line. Auburn's inside the Bama 2 for a second down play. Joseph goes up and over. Joseph is in. Touchdown, Auburn! James Joseph has scored his second touchdown for the Auburn Tigers, who go ahead of the Alabama Crimson Tide with 10:36 remaining in the third quarter by the score of 13-10. This score set up by a big play, Slack to Shane Wasdin, that covered 60 yards. Here comes the Crimson Tide up to the firing line with a new set of down. Hollingsworth will run from the shotgun formation. Auburn almost jumping offside. Four-man Tiger rush. Hollingsworth setting up with plenty of time, and he throws over the middle to a wide-open Kevin Turner. 35-30. Turner still on his feet. Fumbles. Auburn's got it. They took it away from Turner, who lost the handle. Left it on the ground, and it was Dennis Wallace who came up to make the recovery. And that's the first Alabama turnover of the game.
And Auburn dodged a bullet because that was an excellent play. Hollingsworth to one of his favorite receivers, Kevin Turner. And Turner going upfield, finding the going pretty easy until he was really hit by one of the Auburn defenders coming in from the outside. I don't know who it was, but that jarred the ball loose, and that's a big break for Auburn. Again, turnovers going to be the key to the ball game.
From the Tiger 26-yard line, a first down play for Slack. Reggie has an eye formation behind him, and he play fakes. He wants to pass. Sets up, has time, and he's going to air one out. Alexander Wright was pushed off the playing field, came back on the field, caught the ball at the 25 to the 20, and finally was cut down at the 14-yard line. But they're going to say that he was pushed off the field of play. A penalty marker went down, and let's see what the ruling will be. I am reminded of the Auburn-Alabama game when Tom Gossum was pushed off the field of play, Charlie.
Holding on the defense.
Will be the call against Alabama, so the play will stand.
The play stands
and recount what happened, Charlie.
A lot of people are curious when a defensive back pushes you out of bounds, as number five, Ephraim Thomas, pushed Alexander Wright out of bounds. Can you come back in and make the catch? And the answer is yes. You can come back on the playing field and make the catch. It was interference. Had the catch not been made, he made the catch. The interference is declined, and a great play by Reggie Slack and Alexander Wright.
A 60-yard gain to the Alabama 14. It'll be a 22-yard attempt, hardly more than a point after touchdown. Dickinson, the holder, slight angle to the left for Wynn Lyle. Ball on the ground, kick away. Kick is perfect. And Auburn leads Alabama 17-10 with 5:58 left in the third quarter. Right in the slot, Taylor splits away wide. Casey split away 5 yards to this side. And here's a second down and 13. Slack backs up to throw and fires. Casey is catching the ball, I believe. Complete, yes, up at the 45-yard line. Heard Casey did a great job right at the boundary of holding on to that football despite a hard blow by Ephraim Thomas. First down at the 45.
That was a good throw by Reggie Slack. Reggie actually threw the ball a little late. He threw it on an out route. It was a zig out or a flag route. Nice inside post move by Herbert Casey back to the flat. And number five, Ephraim Thomas, was right there when the ball got there. And from here, I didn't think he would be able to hold on to it. A great catch by Herbert Casey.
And they had 152 yards passing to Bama's 94. Finally, we're going to run a play. Second down and 14. Motion by the wide receiver, Taylor. Slack play fake, sets up in the cul-de-sac, and fires out in the flat. Ace Wright's got it for close to a first down, down to the Bama 33-yard line. Covered by John Mangum, Alexander Wright jumped up, pulled that ball down out of the air, and he's very close to a first down at the Bama 33. It is a first down, says referee Al Ford. So Auburn picks up 14, 15 yards on second down.
And that's a product of having to respect the speed of Alexander Wright. John Mangum giving a lot of yardage, a lot of cushion between himself and Alexander, not wanting to get beat deep. And then Reggie Slack made a nice throw because he sidearmed the ball underneath the arm of one of the own rushing Alabama defenders. Great throw by Reggie.
Taylor to the short side. Wright splits away to the left. And Taylor's going in motion. Alabama is showing blitz as Slack going to run the toss sweep to Danley. Sprints through a little seam, broke the tackle, 30, 25, 20, still on his feet to the 15, and on to the 13-yard line. Stacy Danley just sprinted through a little seam, found a little patch of daylight, and he rambles down to the Bama 13-yard line where Hammond and McCants make the tackle. A gain of 20 yards by Stacy Danley.
Toss sweep to the near side. Some good blocking over there by pulling guards and by the fullback, James Joseph, or either Alex Strong. I'm not sure which one, but one of them made a crunching block on the outside. Stacy Danley just keeping those legs pumping, and he broke through some tackles.
Second and nine at the Bama 12. One running back is Lectron Williams behind Reggie Slack. He'll toss sweep. Williams to the short side. He's at the 10. He's at the 5. He's in! Touchdown, Auburn! Gerald Williams, the block thrown by Chris Gray. Auburn 23, Alabama 10.
It was a great move by Darrell Williams to make the cut and not to drag that play out to the sideline. He saw the opening, and he's got that speed. He knows what his strong suit is, and that's quickness and speed. So he jumped it up in the gap, and before Alabama could really pursue and react to the play, he almost scored, and then he was in the end zone.
Lyle for the point after. Dickinson holding. Ball is on the ground. The kick is away. Kick good. Field. 13:04 to play. Auburn 24, Alabama 10. We'll return after this word from All Pro. Hollingsworth lines him up in the shotgun. I've never heard this place as loud as it is right now. David Rocker checks back in at defensive tackle. Here's the shotgun. Hollingsworth fires over the middle, pass intercepted, and then dropped by Darrell Crawford, but I believe they'll give Auburn possession. Let's see. Should give Auburn possession. The ground made him fumble. Auburn's ball, I believe. I believe it's going to go to Auburn. Yes, it will. Auburn's ball. Interception, Darrell Crawford. Ball was rolling loose after he hit the ground, but they rule the ground made the fumble, and that means it belongs to Auburn. So the Tigers have possession of the football, first and 10 at Bama's 35. Auburn up by 14 points, trying to make it 17. Lyle will kick from 31 yards away. No angle. He's right in the middle of the field, kicking out of the hole to Chris Dickinson. Fourth down, and they'll need about three, but they'll forego the first down try for the field goal. And here's the snap to Dickinson. Ball is on the ground. Lyle's kick is perfect. Auburn 27, Alabama 10. And Auburn has 10 men up inside their the Alabama 45 and around midfield. There's the kick. It's a bouncer. It's loose. And Auburn, I believe, is going to come up with it. Yes. Auburn got it.
Jim,
it took a high bounce. I couldn't see. I thought for a moment, Charlie, that Alabama had come up with it, but Auburn ends up with the ball, and I believe it was James Joseph.
Frank McIntosh,
backup quarterback, got it. McIntosh in there. They had some sure-handed people up in the front two rows anticipating the onside kick.
Well, you actually have an onside kickoff receiving team that is made up of members that are not on the kickoff receiving team, but because they have better hands, a lot of receivers, a lot of backs in there, and they don't have too many offensive linemen in there.
Alexander Wright splits away to the left. One running back is Danley. Shane Wasden is to the short side of the right. Slack's going to toss sweep. Danley looking for some running room. 5 yards, 10 yards. Danley bumped out of bounds down at the Alabama 43-yard line. Danley is over the 100-yard mark. 24 carries, 105 yards. Wright to the wide side. Wasden to the short side of the field. Danley's the only setback. Here's Reggie dealing it off to Stacy. Big hole up the middle. He's got a first down to the Alabama 35, and he stretches on to the 34-yard line. Danley found a seam, and McCant defense had to bring him down after he picked up the first and 10 at the Bama 34, and the clock down to a minute 36. All right, here's Auburn. One running back is Danley. Slack, waiting for the snap from Hudson. Reggie, with a long snap count, gives it up the middle to Danley. Sprints through a hole. Danley broke a tackle, broke another tackle. He's all the way down to the Bama 20-yard line for another first down. Danley would not quit, would not be denied. Broke the initial containment, got through another hole, broke another tackle, and just belly rolled, basically, down to the Bama 20. Osmond and Thomas will be credited with the tackle, but Bama is calling another timeout with a minute 29 left. Now, I don't need to tell you the magnitude of this Lyle field goal of 34 yards. Angled to the left, the ball will be placed down on the near side hash mark by Dickinson. There's the kick. Kick is away. Kick is good! Auburn 30, Alabama 20. Celebrating begin.
When Lyle has been...
He's my player of the game.
He really is. He's been perfect today. Been in pressure situations. And I tell you what, he's come through like a champ. When Lyle on the year had had an excellent year. 13 of 16 field goals coming in. Was perfect on PATs, points after touchdown, 24-24. And he has shown... why 2 years ago he was the all-SEC kicker, and really with not a lot of opportunities tried last year, he's come back this year and he's had an outstanding season.
The Auburn sideline is celebrating, and they just brought out the Gatorade jug and they doused Coach Dye. He's soaking wet. Third down and 10 for Hollingsworth. Hollingsworth out of the shotgun is going to throw long. Looking for Sanderson. Knocked down and intercepted. Intercepted by Dennis Wallace. And this, my friends, is history.
Dennis Wallace coming up with a big interception. It was just a jump ball. The jump ball, Dennis Wallace at 6'2 and 200 pounds out of Carrollton, Georgia, had a good leaping ability, and he jumped up and got it. Caught it on a carom off his hands on the way down. So a big play by the Auburn defense to stop Gary Hollingsworth's last ditch effort to get Alabama back in the game. Only 9 seconds to go, Jim.
Well, we're going to let the crowd count this one down. Let them have the fun. Reggie's just going to kneel down after taking the snap from Hudson. That's it. 2 seconds. 1 second. Championship with their fourth consecutive victory over arch rival Alabama. Let's get some of the noise and some of the celebrating, Larry Wilkins. Said Alabama was going to beat us. Where are you now? We'll return with a recap of today's game after these messages on the Auburn Football Network.
First of all, I want to make a presentation. I want to present Coach Dye with the game ball.
Listen, man. Tonight's what our program's all about. I want you to think about it and let it sink in deep. This is the reason we work in the summertime in January and February and the spring. This is the reason we push you beyond what you think you can do to experience moments like this. Ain't no easy way in life, and it wasn't easy out there tonight, but you were prepared for the task at hand. Every one of you players, I mean, I ain't smart enough to tell you how I feel about you. I mean, because it's family, every one of you. I mean, you know it. Sure, I'd like to be 12, 11, and 0, and, you know, not. But I'm going to tell you something. I wouldn't swap this year for any year that I've been at Auburn. I wouldn't swap it, men, because I've watched you struggle, and I watched you wrestle with them angels, but I watched you grow up and become men. I watched you become men. Do you remember me standing right here and telling you when you became one that you'd know it? When you know it now. It don't make any difference who's carrying the ball. It don't make any difference who's catching it, who's rushing the pass, or who's making the tackles. Just as long as you've got a blue jersey on.
Remember, the people on the other side have had a great year. And they won't ever get recognition for the year that they've had. They're an outstanding football team. They came in here not only against a damn good football team, but they came in here with the emotions and set of circumstances where it would have been very, very difficult for them to win.
Tell me about this senior class before you pass out from that cigar.
Well, we're 4 in a row against Bama, 3 conference championships. Could make history if we win the bowl game. I love these guys, and I kept faith. I never thought about losing the whole way.
You can't even explain it. You can't even come close to explaining it.
And then to do it in this setting today when Alabama comes off.
Oh, most definitely. First time here, and your fans and student body, everybody's behind you. It's a great feeling, and the people are behind us all the way.
I can remember if we mess up on one play, they'll put it back on the line, you know, and all the guys were tired, you know. That pulled us together. And, you know, the hard work paid off today.
Yes, I'm glad I came to Auburn. I tried to get my brother to come, but he wanted to go to Alabama, so that's the consequence he had to suffer.
Held him out and let Reggie look downfield and find receivers.
We knew, like, the Georgia game, we knew that'd be a key, because Alabama was, had so many sacks, and they did so many things to rush the passer, and, you know, we knew, or everybody felt like, if we could give Reggie time, that he would make things happen for us, and he did.
None of us had ever seen anything like the Tiger Walk today, and I think the fans had as much to do with it as anything.
That was remarkable.
Oh, it was unbelievable. I mean, you know, we got down there and had to walk single file through the street, and when we came in, we just said, it's over. We're going to win this thing. Somehow, some way, these people want it so bad.
Best senior class that ever came down to fight?
The best one. And I'm proud to be part of it. 3 conference championships, you know. Hey, you can't ask for anything else. I'm just glad to be here.
The people did their job for us, and it was a great win for us.
We go over there in our team meetings a lot, you know. If the defender knock you out, you come back in and try to make a play. I knew that, so I knew I had a good chance of trying to make a catch.
And it worked pretty well. I'm just glad to end out my career and like this, and it makes this whole season worthwhile.
Under the circumstances, that last one was about as big as any of them, you know?
Yeah, it was, put the game away, and, you know, they had to, that was 10 points, and pretty much put them away.
We put points on the board. We ought to do better in spots and places this time, especially when I jumped off sides. But I think plays like it, I mean, we came through, and we did what it took to win. I'm glad we did.
But you scored after you jumped off sides.
So. That's true. So thank goodness Coach Dye might not forgive me for that if I didn't.